Hello, my name is Rukmini Iyer. I am a regular speaker at Help Talks. My professional work is in the space of leadership development on the corporate side and peace building on the socio-political side. And as a coach and as a psychologist, mental health and trauma is very naturally a keen part of my interest as well as professional work. In this particular series of talks, I'm hoping to share with you some thoughts and tips related to the shared experience that all of us have been going through for more than a year now, and that is the collective trauma created by COVID-19. We will explore the impact of the pandemic from a mental health and a trauma perspective. So we're not going to be talking about whether or not you personally ended up being COVID positive, which naturally, of course, is a stressful experience to say the least. But we will really look at the implications of the pandemic in the society that we live in. What is our collective experience around it? There is a lot of debate about whether we can classify what we're going through as trauma, or is it merely stress? Is it regular day-to-day stress? If we have to define and differentiate these two terms, one way of looking at it is that stress is any kind of an uncomfortable experience and situation. It could be uncomfortable in a mental sense, in a physical sense, or in an emotional sense, right? And it's something that we go through every day. For example, if you are in the habit of going for a morning run, at some point in time, if you happen to run beyond what your stamina usually permits you to do, that is a stressful physical experience. Or let's say you've had a really difficult conversation at work with a colleague. It can be a stressful emotional experience. So stress is something that we go through day in and day out. And all of us naturally have our own mechanisms with which to deal with stress and to cope with it in a way that we are still functioning. Trauma, on the other hand, is a little different. If you look at the textbook definition of trauma, one way of defining it is that there is trauma every time there is a breach of a boundary. And that breach of a boundary can be physical in nature. For example, let's say I was in an accident and something hit me. There is physical trauma because my personal physical boundary is breached. It could be emotional trauma where an emotional boundary is breached. For example, if someone happens to use abusive words and those words hurt me, that is an emotional breach that does classify as trauma. And similarly, there could be mental breach as well, mental trauma where you're going through a situation where you're perhaps living in a space where things are not quite working for you. There is perhaps repeated attempts to make you feel uncomfortable and violated. So trauma has a lot to do with repeated exposure to actual death or harm, serious physical harm, injury, violence of any kind. All of that classifies as trauma. And the reason there is debate about whether COVID and the implications that it's caused is stress or trauma is because a lot of the symptoms appear like it is merely stress. It's just added stress in the sense that there is lockdown and economic impact and all of that. And yet the debate about whether it is really trauma or not is critical because it is not merely about personal stress and learning to cope with it. It is something that all of us are going through as a shared experience. And we are not quite there to support each other in a way that we would have been if it was just one person going through stress and another person who was not quite stressed was there available physically, mentally, emotionally, and perhaps even financially to support other people. So what we are going through is collective trauma in many ways, and it is something that none of us alive today have had any experience whatsoever in, because we've not had a pandemic in a really long time, and certainly we've not lived through a pandemic of this scale that we're living through as a society. So the kinds of stresses and trauma that we're going through right now, of course, includes a physical threat that we might be exposed to the virus, and therefore there could be physical danger of contracting it and having sustained impact on in terms of our health and so on. A lot of us may have also experienced the physical threat in the form of our near and dear ones being tested as being COVID positive. Some of us may have perhaps even lost people that we know, and that definitely is a threat in many, many ways, physically, mentally, emotionally, socially, perhaps even financially, and so on. Most of us would have perhaps experienced some kind of economic stress around COVID and the subsequent lockdown and the quarantine that it caused, because our livelihoods may have been impacted, perhaps some of us lost jobs. And hence, there is definitely an impact on mental health as a collective. Of course, we're going through what we're going through as an individual, but there is also a collective impact which adds on to the individual experience of COVID-19. So if you're experiencing any of these symptoms that you see here, which could include mild irritability, being locked down, being perhaps in a home with many people and not having the ability to step out as you could earlier before the pandemic, is certainly a sign that trauma is perhaps building up. There could be disturbances of various kinds that you are experiencing, anxiety, worry about the future, and worry at various levels. It could be financial worries, physical health worries. It could be worry about education, your jobs, your growth professionally and personally, and so on. Some of us may have experienced loss of people, loss of relationships, loss of opportunities. And all of this put together could have perhaps left us sad in many ways. Now, the degree of sadness could differ person to person. It also is impacted by the amount of support that we have in our environment or the lack of it. And having said that, the sadness at this point is universal, because all of us are collectively grieving the loss of at least a year, which has been extremely different from any year that we have lived through in the past. And it is important that we stay compassionate to ourselves and to people around us as we go through this. In this series of talks, we will look at various lenses and aspects of this collective trauma that we're going through. And we will also discuss ways in which we can cope personally, as well as help people around us to cope. The tip that I want to share with you in this particular talk is around grounding and resourcing. It is something that you can develop as a regular daily practice, sometimes even practice it multiple times a day. And it is also something that you can specifically bring into practice in the moments that you feel extreme or heightened stress or trauma. It's a really simple practice which you can do anywhere that you are. All you need is access to the ground. And when I mean ground, it could be the floor of the house that you live in. It could be the ground that you're walking on outside. Any surface. It could perhaps even be the bed that you're lying down on. That can be a ground. But all we're looking for is access to a stable surface that helps you experience the pull of gravity in a safe physical manner. So the grounding exercise goes something like this. If you can, ideally take your shoes off or your footwear off and try and physically feel your feet on the ground, on the surface that you are in. If possible, try and put your feet down in a way that you're able to feel the surface. If you happen to be on a bed, if you're sitting cross-legged, it's all right to also feel the space where your feet touch the surface that you're sitting on or lying down on. And that's the first step in grounding, to notice and really physically experience how the ground, the surface that you're on, is holding you, how gravity operates in a way that you're not flying off, and to experience that trust and that consistency of gravity that holds us all and we build our lives around it. That's the first step in grounding. The second step is to take a few moments, perhaps a few seconds, if you want a few minutes, to notice the different sensations that you feel in your body. What we mean by sensations are physical experiences. For example, you might feel that a certain part of your body feels warmer in temperature than a certain other part. Another example of a sensation is where the way your muscles feel. For example, the muscles in a certain part of your body may feel contracted, while certain other parts of your body may feel more relaxed. There could be other sensations that you feel on your skin, such as feeling an itch in a certain part of the skin, or feeling the cool breeze flow onto your skin. Those are examples of sensations. So notice the sensation while you are grounded. And there could be multiple sensations happening simultaneously in different parts of your body. And as you notice this, there's no need to change anything that you're feeling. It's all right if you feel pain, if you experience a sensation that is uncomfortable, that's absolutely okay. But take your attention to parts of your body that feel good, parts of your body that are not hurting, that feel comfortable, even if they're neutrally comfortable. They don't have to feel good in a positive sense. It could simply be a neutral comfort. So simply notice which parts of your body feel that sense of comfort. To add to resources, aside from the physical body, if you like, you may also wish to think up of memories, ideally in the recent past, perhaps on that day or on that week, where you had a pleasant memory. And a pleasant memory could be a really simple thing, something as simple as someone getting you a glass of water when you were thirsty, or someone making a meal for you at home, or perhaps a friend calling you up in a way that was unexpected and asking how you were doing. All of those are resources that can be extremely nourishing for our body and our emotions. So try and access emotions and memories that are fairly current and that feel good to you. These are huge resources in helping you ground yourself better. And finally, it may also help if you have a certain space that you're operating from, a certain physical space where you're working from home, or perhaps some of you might be going to work places regularly. Try and place materials around you that feel like resources, that feel good when you look at them. For example, it could be a small potted plant on your desk. It could be a photograph of someone that you love. It could perhaps be a painting on the wall that you can easily look at and feel inspired by. And placing these physical resources around you really helps in adding to your immunity. It helps in adding to your sense of nourishment. Nourishment that we take in is not only through food. We take in nourishment through all our senses, through the music that we listen to, through the visuals that we see around us, through perhaps nice textures that we are able to touch, through perhaps a bed sheet that you can easily touch and feel good about. So use all your senses to nourish yourself. And while this seems like a simple, perhaps even a silly exercise when we talk about grounding and resourcing, making it a regular practice has a very direct impact on enhancing your immune system. And that is something that all of us could do better at in the times that we live in. So that's a practice that I invite you to incorporate in your life every day, perhaps even multiple times a day. And it's something that does not take much. It doesn't take too long. It can be done anywhere that you are in. All you need to do is very consciously physically ground and feel how gravity operates with your body, and then start accessing internal and external resources that can make you feel nourished and feel good. That's the first step in managing oneself when we are living through collective trauma. Thank you for watching this video, and in the upcoming videos of the series, I will share more tips around how we can work through this shared experience that all of us are going through. Till then, take care.
Help Talks are daily health-related talks held at Health Education Library for People, Mumbai, India. For more information, visit www.healthlibrary.com. Subscribe to Help Talks channel. Be better informed about your health.